Ever wanted to be invisible? Well, science is getting closer to making that fantasy a reality. Hey guys, Julia here for D News. So invisibility cloaks seem like the realm of fantasy, but science is working on it. We see things when light bounces off an object and reaches our eyes. To make something invisible to our eyes, researchers have to find ways to bend light or other forms of electromagnetic radiation around an object. Previous versions of an invisibility cloak were less of a cloak and looked more like a medical device. One involved a series of lenses that bend light around an object. You can find out more about that here in Amy's video. But scalability proved to be an issue. It couldn't cover large or irregularly shaped objects like a human body, for example. It was really limited to simple objects like a cylinder and only at specific viewing angles. If you were to walk around the object, it would be visible. But in the 2 years since, other researchers have come up with their own versions of an invisibility cloak. A team of researchers at UC Berkeley came up with a metamaterial that's super thin, according to a paper published in the journal Science. The thin cloak is only 80 nanometers thick, made up of tiny gold antennas that make you think you're looking at a flat surface instead of a three-dimensional object. It's because this metamaterial changes the way light is scattered. When we look at someone, our brains work to interpret the way light is scattered by their face and body. But the cloak disrupts the way light scatters, so instead of seeing the person in front of us, we would see a flat surface. Pretty clever, huh? One of the authors of the study told the Washington Post that each antenna is designed to react with the light and scatter it back. And it's so thin that it actually acts like a cloak by wrapping around the object it's hiding. The benefit of this material is that it can cloak irregularly shaped objects like the human body, for example. But don't get too excited. So far, the material can only cover an object about 1 square millimeter, or about the size of a grain of sand. So that's very tiny, and only at a very specific wavelength of light. So while we're inching closer to a true invisibility cloak, we've got some major hurdles to jump over first. Since we're playing with light waves, embedding them and scattering them at will, things start to get a little strange. It does a weird timey-wimey thing. In reflecting and scattering light, it actually delays light. It delays the reflection. So there's a lag effect where the image appears slower than the thing that it's reflecting. Like time is moving at two different rates. So if you're walking by a cloaked invisible box, a bird flying by would pass at normal speed, but if it flew inside the box, it would be a few seconds slower. And most of the cloaks so far have to stay still. As soon as you move, the illusion is broken. You've heard of the Doppler effect. It's where the sound of pitch changes as objects move past you, and that's because of how the sound waves are emitted when an object is moving fast. It changes the space between the waves, thus changing the pitch. And according to a study published in the journal Physical Review A, a similar thing causes a fast-moving cloaked object to appear visible. Basically, the frequency of the light waves changes as an object moves, which causes distortions in the image. And as the object moves faster, these changes get more noticeable, which kind of defeats the purpose of a cloak in the first place. The other issue with these kinds of invisibility cloaks is that while it might make an object invisible, if someone were inside of that object, they couldn't see out. But this paper also makes the case that these distortions might actually enable someone in the cloak to be able to see out. So perhaps there's solutions on the horizon for some of the tricky science behind invisibility cloaks. For now, I'm just gonna go read some fantasy books until science perfects it. If you want an incredible behind-the-scenes look at the James Webb Space Telescope, make sure to check out Discovery's brand new documentary, Telescope. The world premiere is this Saturday, February 20th at 9 p.m. on the Discovery Channel. We'll be watching too. It's crazy to think about how technology is making fantasy a reality. Like, scientists are already working on mind control. To learn more about that, check out this episode right here. Recently, Chinese researchers introduced a prototype for a mind-controlled car. This particular technology uses an EEG, or electroencephalogram, made up of 16 sensors on a cap that reads electric signals from the brain. All right, guys, so what kind of tech do you want to see in the future? Invisibility cloaks, mind control? Let us know down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to D News so you don't miss a single episode.